For me, art is just, it's a bunch of things. It's a way to distract myself when my brain is being anxious and trying to scare me, or my body is trying to scare me. It's also a way to get what's in my head out and onto paper. And that can be, you know, art can be for yourself. It can just be about, you know, something private just to get it out and down that you don't have to look at again. Or it can be for you to share with people without having to use words how you're feeling. You can, I mean, a picture can say a lot, and a picture can resonate in different ways than you intend it to as well. The one pic comic strip that I like, the me versus them comic strip, it's a great way for me to show kind of how I deal with those nights when my partner gets to go out with all our friends and I get to sit on the toilet for 3 hours. Yay, you know, like, and I find that as I do more art, I get better at art, and I have what I call an art journal now, and I challenged myself for a couple of months to do a piece of art every day in this book. And what I've got is this big, beautiful book of art that I can feel proud of, that makes me feel like I've done something productive because it's there in front of me. And when you can't work because you're too sick, it's hard to feel useful. It's hard to feel like you do things that count. And the art journal for me has really been this, like, this way to show that I can make beautiful things and that I can do things and that I am useful and that I am creative. And it's not just me sitting at home watching Netflix, thinking about how crappy things are, you know? And so, I mean, some of the pieces are specifically about being sick, and some of them aren't. Some of them are just silly and goofy, and I'm really concentrated on faces right now. I love doing faces. Yeah, and it's all about trying new techniques, and every 6 weeks I get bored of what I'm doing and I try something new. And it's been like that pretty much since I first stopped working. I took up crocheted for a year, made some really cool things, got pretty good at it, and then got bored of it. And so I moved on to drawing or music, or art doesn't have to be about visual art. It can be audio or anything that makes you feel good and makes you feel like you're not just sitting around wasting, you know, like wasting away. That's a hard feeling to overcome, I think, for a lot of folks, especially when you are really limited in your physicality. Like, it's hard to find something that you can do physically that also gives you that satisfaction. And also, being poor and being able to create art means you have gifts to give. And you don't have to worry about, like, how am I going to afford a Christmas gift for everybody? Oh, see that giant chest of yarn? That's how. Yeah, and people like to give you presents when you're sick. I don't know if you've found that at all, but people, when they don't know what to say, they like to give gifts, and I get the best gifts of art supplies. It's been awesome. Yeah, I've been really lucky. People have been really generous with me, not just with gifts, but with their time and stuff as well. But I've gotten quite a few really cool art lessons and art experiences, which it really connects with me. Having something to feel proud of when you can't work and you can't contribute is really, like, irreplaceable.